Another tragedy in Japan. Authorities are looking into negligence as a possible cause in the Tokyo runway collision that left 5 people dead. The police probe got underway as officials began looking for clues in the charred wreckage of a Japan Airlines plane. The escape of all 379 people on board the Airbus A350 on Tuesday was deemed a miracle after it erupted into flames after colliding with a smaller aircraft. 5 of the 6 Coast Guard crew on board the Dash 8 plane were killed. They were previously responding to the earthquake in Noto Peninsula. Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida says delivery of aid to quake-hit areas are unaffected.
With regards to your question about whether the accident at Haneda Airport is affecting delivery of aid to quake-hit zones, at the moment, various ministries are working together and have secured various routes. I believe the accident at Haneda Airport has had no impact on aid delivery.
The latest on the powerful quake that hit Japan on New Year's Day. At least 64 people are confirmed dead from the 7.6 quake that struck the Noto Peninsula Monday afternoon. Now, this makes a disaster the deadliest earthquake Japan has seen since 2016. Authorities are ramping up the delivery of aid as survivors face the threat of freezing temperatures and potential landslides. Heavy rainfalls, severed roads and damaged infrastructure also complicating rescue efforts.
We ask local residents to be on the alert for landslides and act with safety in mind. It's been over 40 hours since the earthquake. It's a race against time to rescue victims, and we are at a crucial stage. Today, we will increase the number of self-defense forces search and rescue teams from 1,000 to 2,000, double the number of police and self-defense forces rescue dogs to strengthen the teams. We are putting lives first and making the utmost effort to rescue and save people.
Philippine state seismologists not expecting any damage to infrastructure in Surigao del Sur after a magnitude 5.1 quake rattled the eastern Mindanao province. The country's chief seismologist, Teresita Bacolcol, says the tremor is an aftershock of the magnitude 7.4 quake that hit eastern Mindanao in December. Meanwhile, Bacolcol assures the public the Bulusan volcano is not erupting anytime soon despite its heightened seismic activity. But he urges local governments and the public to stay away from the volcano's 4-kilometer permanent danger zone.
There are other parameters that we are watching, such as elevated levels of steam or gas emission, sustained inflation of the edifice, of the edifice of Bulusan volcano, and increase in hot spring temperature. So if there are sustained increases in these parameters, then we have to raise this to alert level 2.
Here at home, the Philippine government is set to launch more floating assets in the West Philippine Sea. The Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources says these assets are meant to help Filipino fishermen and assert Manila's sovereignty in waters illegally claimed by China. The agency, however, did not provide specifics on what form these assets will take. The BFAR also says they are in close coordination with the National Task Force on the West Philippine Sea.
Doon po kami sumisentro sa paggawa ng mga programa para po sa West Philippine Sea. Masiguro natin na mayroong livelihood opportunities, may tamang suporta ang ating mga mangisda dyan dahil alam naman po natin, kinikilala natin sa ngayon na mayroon tayong hamon na hinaharap sa West Philippine Sea. Pero hindi naman ibig sabihin ito dahil may hamon tayong hinaharap ay titigil na tayo sa pagpapatupad ng ating mga programa.
The total number of firecracker-related injuries in the Philippines, it's 557. The Health Department recorded 114 new cases from January 2 to 3. Majority of the cases were due to firecrackers. Some even resulted in amputations. A 6-year-old priest in Baguio City was also hit by a stray bullet during the New Year revelries. He is in stable condition. A former Philippine lawmaker raises the alarm over the chilling effect of the Anti-Terrorism Act on the political opposition. This is a day after the Supreme Court released its implementing rules for the law. Attorney Nery Colmenares, one of the petitioners against the law, says it's meant to silence the opposition. He also suspects authorities will continue to conduct surveillance activities on suspected terrorists even without an order from the Court of Appeals. Colmenares insists an anti-terror law is the last thing that the Philippines needs, as there are other laws that address terrorism.
The Commission on Higher Education reminds state universities and colleges to discontinue their senior high school programs. It says the programs should only be offered during the K-12 transition period that ended in 2021. CHED Chairman Prospero De Vera explained there should be no more government assistance to student and teacher beneficiaries for school year 2023 to 2024.